Good morning. I'm starting my day off awesomely with a smoothie. The only thing that would make this more awesome is if it had a bendy straw. And I'm also watching Catfish season 2. Pretty excited about that. So yum. Here's to a delicious start to the day. It's actually kind of nice outside, so I was gonna open the sliding glass door and just leave the screen door so that we could get the fresh air. But there is a wasp nest like inside, so I can't leave the door open. But I wanted to show you guys how nice it was out here. Oh, it's gonna rain. I didn't even notice that. Dang it. Well, it feels good at least. Yeah. Look who's home. Are you ready to get insane?
Smiling because I love it. We just dropped the car off, so I think we're gonna try to walk over to Tarrigate here and maybe get a few Shopkick points while we're at it. We're like walking behind this bar and grill here. Oh my goodness, it smells so good. It smells like chicken wings. I love chicken wings. It sounds so good. Literally, every time we come into Target, Jen has to come over here and look at the bathing suits. Because she has one that is on, she thinks might be on sale.
I like this.
Oh yeah, it's pretty nice.
So cute.
I'd wear it. No, it's for me. It's a giant necktie for the 4th of July.
I think it's for your dog.
I think it's for babies. This one, the bow tie. Yes. Why would you pay a dollar for that cup?
Oh, it's pretty, like, feel it.
Is it? Oh, yeah, it's, like, made of glass.
It's my Red Solo cup.
Made of glass.
It's not, is it?
It's ceramic, or is it? No, it's plastic. No, it's just
really thick plastic.
What the heck? Still, I'd just get a regular one.
I just buy all these Tootsie Rolls.
Chalk holders were always the thing when you were in school. Like, when you were going to write something on the chalkboard, you always try to get the teacher's piece of chalk that has the chalk holder. That was the good stuff. Yeah, and maybe a little bit of rum in there, too. That is a giant eraser.
I feel like you must make a ton of mistakes if you use this.
You're terrible at life. I'll be honest, I don't understand what the relationship between a magnifying glass bookmarker and a digital camera is. How do I look?
Beautiful, darling. I love it.
It feels so strange on me.
What, you're not used to wearing jewelry? I think this is fun.
I think it's not fun. This is awesome. In the dollar section, for $3, they have this flashing ball that's on a string, just like they sell at Universal, for $20. Brilliant.
The purse you'll never lose.
Yeah, it's like safety orange.
I like it.
It kind of looks like Daily Grace to me.
I must ask you a question about your glasses.
Oh yeah?
Are they women's glasses?
I think so.
They look so awesome on you. You should buy them.
No.
All right.
You love all these beachy smells? That's lavender. No, it's not.
What is it? It's Moonlit Walk.
Oh, that sounds fancy.
This is my favorite one.
What is it? Tropical?
Tropical Lay. Ooh. It smells so good.
I can't wait to have a Tropical Lay. That looks good. That looks good. That does not. What are these? Potato chips for dogs?
They are.
Yeah. These are dog cookies.
Yum, they look so good. Really good. Yeah. And look at these bitty bites. I know what that means. That's a bad word.
Who is that? He's not even blue and he's on drugs.
Maybe that's why he's not blue.
So we found this magazine that has these cupcakes on the top and we wanted to see how to make them.
It says it's on the cover, but then it doesn't tell me how to make it.
Not right there. It tells you. That's the
recipe. Wait, is this it? It says make up a batch of your favorite yellow cupcakes. Oh, this is it.
Yeah, and then just add whipped cream and strawberries.
Oh, that's terrible. Annoying.
It's a pretty good idea. It's got two lenses on it so that you can face one forward and one backwards, and it's like a GoPro almost, where it's like waterproof. I don't know, I'd still rather have a GoPro. Ooh, somebody's got new shoes. So because that Duncan Hines peanut butter brownie mix was on sale for $1.75 or something like that.
Did we show them?
And we had, I showed them in the store, and we had $1.75 at I found $2 the other day at work. We bought it. We're gonna not use it until not this Sunday.
What are we gonna do? Save it for
Sunday. Save it for Sunday. Not this Sunday, but next Sunday, because this Sunday we're doing something else. You guys will find out on Sunday. And then next Sunday we don't have anything planned, so we're gonna make chocolate chip peanut butter yumminess. Maybe we'll make the cookies. They have cookies with peanut M&Ms, and that looks delicious. For the 4th of July, what's more American than red, white, and blue raviolis? In the newspaper this morning, there was a theme park word quiz.
It's new theme park terms.
And Jen's gonna quiz me on them.
Yes.
I have to guess what they are.
So the first one is TCDM.
TCDM.
Yeah.
I feel like it's an acronym for talking in turn, can you make me pie?
No, it's, you're close. It's It's the paralysis experienced at Disney World's Ticket and Transportation Center when trying to decide means of transportation to Magic Kingdom. And the example is, Tecedium set in as our group debated the merits of monorail travel versus the ferry boat experience.
Hmm. Always choose monorail because it's faster. Even though the ferry boat does have a quite awesome reveal of the Magic Kingdom, the castle come across the lake.
And the second one is Mantis.
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 Those are when fat people are walking around the park and you look down at their legs and you're like, man, look at them thighs. And you're like, man, look at them mantis. What is it?
It's causing a fainting spell during the first loop of the Manta roller coaster at SeaWorld Orlando. The example is the G-forces may mantis a few guests, but folks are soon flying above the theme park with ease.
Oh, like paralyzed, but you've been mantised.
You've been mantised.
All right, what's next? Give me the next one.
Potterbon.
Ruff. Potterbon?
Mm-hmm.
That is a Cinnabon that you buy at the Cinnabon store in CityWalk and then walk into Harry Potter Land and eat it.
No.
Wearing a wizarding cloak with a Expelliarmus.
Expelliarmus. It's staring at Wizarding World of Harry Potter construction at Universal Studios. Example, when a Buzz Cola could not shake Greg from a severe state of Potterbon. Pottery Barn.
Pottery Barn. That's like me when I was on the Dueling Dragons taking video of the construction of the Hogwarts Express.
Yeah, you were Potterbon.
I was Potterbon.
This one's the most fun one to say. It's Shamu Shamoozled.
Shamu Shamoozled.
Yeah.
That is when you've been bamboozled by Shamu. This is, I'm starting to pick up on their terminology. So it's when you're getting your picture taken with the character that's dressed up as Shamu, and then he goes in for a shift change right before it's your turn. So you're like, all right, I'm next in line. Shift change. I've been Shamoozled.
No, that's actually probably a better one than what it is. It's acting shocked by getting wet while sitting in the splash zone at SeaWorld's Shamu Stadium. The example is, those kids appear completely shamoozled after the killer whales took aim at them. The next one is faux ghost hosting.
Okay. Faux ghost hosting is when you are in line at Pecos Bills and you're waiting to for the person that you're with to buy their food, and you stand over next to the host and you act like you have food so that they give you a table and you're like, I've got food. It's coming. Because they won't seat you at Pecos Bills unless you have food.
That is completely wrong. You're right about what you're saying, but your answer is wrong. It's irritating fellow Magic Kingdom guests by speaking along with the Haunted Mansion narrator. This room has no windows and no doors. And the example is, yes, we know you've been in the stretching room before. Stop faux ghost hosting.
But you could always choose my way out.
Okay, good green golly.
Good green golly. Good green golly. I don't know what's green in the theme parks. That's where you eat green eggs and ham at Universal's Green Eggs and Ham in Seuss Landing. And then you throw up and you go, good green, good. And you throw up all kinds of greeny goodness. Even though it's not bad, it's actually quite tasty. It just tastes like eggs and ham, colored green.
It's not that. It's a family-friendly expletive uttered during the lift hill for the Incredible Hulk coaster at Islands of Adventure. The example is, we were moving slowly and tension was building, then good green golly, it took off like a bullet.
And then you say, this time, I think it's gonna work. Warning! No! Good green golly!
Don't faux ghost host my Hulk ride.
Oh.
And then the very last one is Uzz.
Uzz. That's when you are up at the front counter and you're getting ready to buy your theme park ticket, and then they tell you the price, and then you act like you don't have any money to try to get in for free, and you're like, I don't know what happened to my credit card. Can we go in for free?
I like that answer. I don't think it would work. But it's people who are rendered speechless when it's their turn to order at counter service restaurants. Example, just our luck. After waiting in line for 20 minutes for lunch, it turns out we're stuck between two who still don't know what they want to eat.
That was Jen
the other week or the other day when we went to the Earl of Sandwich, she was like, oh, I don't know what I'm gonna get. I don't. And then she decided right before she went up to the register. I think my definitions of these words were a lot better.
You got a 0 out of 7, so fail.
And what did you get out of 7?
I read all the answers.
So uh-huh. So you didn't get any of them right.
No,
so I win.
Mm-hmm.
Now that we're done with the errands, we should watch a movie. We're gonna watch Where the Wild Things Are because we never actually saw it. I hope it's good. That was a pretty darn good movie. Jen cried. I thought that they should show that movie to psych students because it's a pretty darn good representation of, like, all kinds of things that go on in the mind of a child. It was good. Hey, Bandit, thanks for showing me your junk. A lot of you guys have been asking me for shout-outs. I don't do shout-outs, I'm sorry. I get too many of them a day. But what I do, is have you guys send me a video of yourself saying, and now it's time to pay the price, and I put your channel across the bottom or across the top of the screen so that everybody knows who you are. So send me your videos. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, I don't know, some way. So I'll see you guys tomorrow. And now it's time to pay the price.